Hi, everybody. It's me. It's Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College with another COVIDio. Happy April 20th today, where today I decided not to run the Boston Marathon. I know you were all expecting that, and it didn't happen. Temperature today is 96 degrees Fahrenheit or 35.6 centigrade. I'm going to start with it's been a very big weekend since I last talked to you, and there's much going on. First of all, right after I got talking to you, there was a big blow up on everything that happened. First of all, there was a revision of the number of cases in Ohio. I'm going to get to that later. And there's been all kinds of concerns about all the good work that we've been doing and whether it's going to hold. I'm still very optimistic. There have been a number of protests that have occurred about the stay-at-home orders, and some of them, I think you can see from the pictures, almost look like they might be a little bit violent. I know the governor of Ohio has resorted to protective activity. There also may be some other kinds of things going on, there are people intentionally, bad players, bad actors who are intentionally spreading the virus for, shall we say, nefarious reasons. We'll just leave it at that and not go any farther than that. So the protesters are, running the risk of having things get reinvigorated. And one thing that this picture here, I'm showing you a picture of I believe that is a nurse who is counter-protesting a protester. I gotta hand it that this picture is burnt into my memory for probably my whole life, because there is somebody who puts their life on their line and is defending the right to put their right on their life on the line. And I just think, let that soak in a little bit. There's somebody who's risking their own health to help others, and they're also risking their own safety by preventing others from stopping them. This is a responsibility. This is something that we all have to do together, just like in World War II. People worked together for a common goal, and we did it. And we will do this too, and we're going to make our best effort. A lot of people are saying that that this is not a serious kind of thing. I will tell you, last week I presented data that showed it was the second deadliest disease in the United States, and now it's number one. If you take the number of people who have heart disease divided into 52, that gives you the number per week. And now COVID-19 of that last week in April was number one. So we are talking about a very serious kind of thing, and it's a very serious disease that we're hopefully going to get under control soon. I mean, really soon, and then we can move. One of the things we don't want to do is open up too soon. If we open up too soon, what happens is that we run the risk of having to close a second time. If we have to close a second time, I will guarantee you many businesses will fail, because they will spend their life capital to try to get it reopened again, and then to close again wouldn't be able to happen. So I think that once we open, we need to do it right and appropriately and smart. We need to be very smart about what it is that we're doing there. All right, let me move into the big development over the weekend. There was a tremendous surge in cases of COVID-19. Not a surge in deaths at this point, but there was a huge jump in cases. We were heading towards a peak, and all of a sudden we got into a big surge, and it was really due to one kind of a thing, and that is a prison in Ohio. The largest source of infections in the United States of America right now is in Marion County. And that is there's a huge outbreak going on in that prison. And again, it's hard to maintain social distance in a prison. That is kind of what the governor has been mentioning. And that just shows you how not getting together with other people is saving us. The fact that people who have to stay together in prisons, because that is the law, they're getting infections at such a high level, that should be evidence to show you that this is working, that we are on the right course, that we are doing things correctly. And then I'm just going to finish that last picture with a picture from the counties. Cuyahoga County in Ohio was number one. It's now Marion County, where that prison is. So we got a whole bunch of new cases. All right, I want to just leave you with this whole thought of starting back too early. And I'll show you this last picture here. This is from Denver. This is from 1918. So I'm using some rather old data here. But this is the 1918 flu epidemic. And you can see they started putting into interventions. The interventions were doing a good job at controlling the infection. Unfortunately, they removed the interventions too soon. Everybody had a big celebration. And in that big celebration, they ended up having a second wave of disease that was more deadly than the first. So this is my point here. You know, we are doing the right thing. This is the right thing. It may be painful. We'll all talk about it someday. But be the helper. Be the good people that look out for each other. And looking out for each other right now is staying home. Even more importantly now than ever, because it's starting to get nice outside and it's starting to look like you want to get out. Remember to wear masks when you go out. If you do go out, wear masks. There are a lot of people who are counting on you to make their lives easier. The people who are working in the healthcare situation right now need you to do this and need you to help them so that they don't have to, make more of a sacrifice than they are. I'm going to stop right there and thank you all for tuning in. Just remember to be good to each other. And may you all persist like a lentivirus. Thank you.